In this video, I'm going to explain how I shot this photo and how I made it look like this inside Lightroom. In other words, I will show you my end-to-end workflow. So let's start with lighting. It was golden hour and we placed the car so it was backlighted. Backlighting is a technique in which light is placed behind the subject or at a certain angle to create depth and separation between background and subject. The camera that I use is my trustworthy Fujifilm X-T4 in pair with Sigma 30mm f1.4. This is currently my favorite lens. That is it about lighting and equipment, so let's jump into Lightroom and start editing. Today we're going to work on this image, and firstly let's understand what is this red mess. So it means that we don't have any details in the highlights and we're clipping. To turn this off and on, you just have to click on this triangle here and we have the same for shadowy areas. So let's crush the blacks and you can see this bluish thing appeared here. It means that we don't have details in the shadows, and this means that we don't have any details in the highlights. So that's about that. I'm always trying to shoot for the highlights in these conditions because it's easier to recover shadows than the highlights. So it's kind of general rule, but you have to go and test your own camera. So that's about that. And I can go like and slap my preset here and do a couple tweaks, couple masks and call it a day, but we're going to do everything from the scratch. So first thing that I like to do is I like to click auto and see what Lightroom will offer us. So you can see that we're clipping in the tire, and obviously I need to go and rise the blacks because I don't want to lose any details in my tire. So that's about that. Let's just bring the exposure a bit up. Let's introduce a contrast. I'm pretty happy with that. Let's just open up the shadows. So I want this to be bright image. So that's about that. Let's just go, and you can see that I'm clipping, but honestly, I'm not that much thinking about that part because my focus is on a car itself. So we can go and do something like this. So it's already getting, like, the light is getting shaped on our car, and let's just go and lower the clarity a bit. Vibrance, let's go with 0. Saturation, let's go to negative value. And I know this looks a bit flat here, but we will introduce the colors later. So let's do a simple S-curve with a fade. Let's just do something like this. Okay, I think this is good. Let's just lower, and you can hold alt to move these points slower, so something like this. Okay, I'm happy with it, and let's go to the HSL and start to play with colors actually. And I don't think that we have a lot of red in here, so we will leave it as is. The oranges, let's go to +2. Yellows, I don't think that, yeah, I don't think that we're going to touch yellows. Greens, like, there's not much greens, but let's go with negative value with greens. Aqua, so I don't see a lot of aqua, maybe in the windshield. Yeah, we have this aqua here, and let's go towards the blue part here, and let's go and see. So there's a lot of blues in the car, so let's go more to the tealish side. So that's about that. And let's just see, okay, there's a lot of purple in the hood, right, and in the headlights itself. So let's go again towards the blue tealish side here, and magenta, I don't see actually anything, maybe in the this area here. Let's go with red here. Okay, let's just go to the saturation now, and let's see reds. So we can see that we have some gunk in the asphalt, so I don't want to introduce that. So let's go with the red the negative value. So the oranges, let's just go again the opposite way. So like something like negative 50 should do the trick. Yellows, I don't want to touch actually yellows. Greens, let's go with something negative, but like it's not going to affect anything. So aqua, there's not much aqua, so just let's go with negative 100. And blues, let's go to negative 47. Yeah, this looks good. Okay, so purple, I don't like those two colors, so let's just go with negative 50 something. Luminance, so red, I don't like to introduce the red, so let's just leave it at the negative values. Let's just make it brighter, the oranges and the yellows, something like this. I know image looks dull a bit, but we're going to introduce color later. So greens, so you can see we have this area where we have greens, so just leave it as is, or like plus 10. Okay, so the aquas, let's see what we have again. Windshield, like let's go with plus 20 maybe. Let's see how it looks. Yeah, maybe like plus 10 should do the trick. Okay, so what's next? Like purple, yeah, we have purple and magenta, so let's go 22 each. Okay, that's about that. And let's go down color grading. I want to introduce a warmth in the highlights, so I'm going to go to 54, something like this, and let's bump up the saturation to plus 20 and the balance all the way to the 100. So you can see we warmed up the image quite a bit. We're not going to touch this sharpening because honestly I don't like to do it. The image is sharp enough for me at this stage, so don't forget to take this, remove chromatic aberrations. Okay, that's about that. No post crop vignetting, and well, we will add the grain in the later stages. So let's go to the calibration actually, and let's start messing with it. So let's just try to go to something like this, maybe the greens. Let's go to the this, and let's just go a bit negative. So if you want your images to pop, you just can go to the calibration and raise the saturation to something like this, and you can see that all the colors comes to life. So that's about that. And I want to go to the tealish side a bit. So you can think of the calibration as a general tool to shift the colors, and like plus 2 here in the tint. Okay, so this looks good at the moment. So let's go back to the curves and let's start to introduce a bit more colors in this image. So let's go with the red channel, and again we're going to create S curve here. So let me just reset the channel and let me explain. So you can see this is the red and this is the cyan here. If I'm going to go up here, it will introduce a lot of red in the image, and the opposite will introduce cyan in the image. So this is the shadowy areas, this is the highlight areas. So we're going to separate it by a middle dot here, and we're going to
go and create a couple dots here. So let's just start with this, and I'm going to like really introduce a lot of a teal in the shadowy areas here. So something like this, maybe just a tiny bit up. And let's introduce warmth in the highlights. So you can see there's a lot of warmth introduced, maybe not this much. So this should do the trick, right? And let's go to the green. I know it looks kind of weird now, but we will balance it with green and blue channels here. So again, we're doing the same. Oops, I just missed. So something like this. And again, while we're introducing, oops, we're introducing greens in the highlights. And let's go and introduce a lot of purplish mass in the shadowy areas, something like this, but we will balance it with blue. Let's just go and do something like this, and let's skip to the blue channel. So again, we're creating our dots here, and so pushing blues in the highlights, not that much. So you can see here the changes that we're doing. So you can see it to something like this, and let's just introduce a bit, like, let's just do something like this. Okay, so that's about that. I'm pretty happy with where we are now. Maybe it's a bit saturated, and we can go and massage the curves again, like something like so, maybe. Yeah, so this is our start point, and from this I'm going to go to the masks, and I'm going to select the subject, and you can see that it selects the road itself with the subject. So what you can do is you can go and to subtract and click on the brush and start like removing the parts if you feel that you don't need those. So let's make brush a bit bigger, so something like this. I'm not going to be that much accurate here, so we can remove this part here that is obviously not our subject. So something like this should do the trick, and you can go and refine it, but for the sake of this tutorial, I'm not going to do that. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to intersect this mask with linear gradient, and I'm going to do a mask like this. And why I want to do this with gradient, so basically sun is hitting from this side, and I feel like the top of the car should be brighter than the bottom of the car, so that's why we're working with the linear gradient. So I'm going to go to something 0.26, and let's just see before and after, so you can see it made our car pop a bit more. So that's about that. And I want to darken the road, so I'm going to go to linear gradient, and I'm going to pull this from the bottom part, and I'm going to like darken it to something like this. And we're shaping your view to the car, because this is our main subject. So that's about that. And I'm going to go and select the sky. So it's pretty good selection there, and I'm going to darken the sky. So I'm going to go to negative 45, and let's just go and add a dehaze a bit. So this is about it, and I'm pretty happy with where we are now. But I'm going to do one more trick. So I'm going to add radial gradient in here, and from here I'm going to subtract our subject once more, so you can see that we're not affecting the car, And I'm going to go to the dehaze and dehaze it a bit, like so. Let me show you what this actually do for us. It separates our car from the background a bit more. So you can see in here, in this little preview, it just makes the car pop a bit more, in my opinion. So that's about that actually. And what I want to do, I want to work on the lights. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to the brush. Let's just make it smaller, like so. And I'm going to paint over these areas here, this angel lights, like so. And this part as well, like this thing here. And do the same for the next one. Now let's just do the same for this fog lights here. Okay, so what I want to do is just go slightly up with the exposure, like this. Let's see before and after. So, and next thing that I want to do is I want to dehaze it, like dehaze the hell out of those. And let's just zoom in and see. So this is before and this is after. You can see that it's nice halo. So it's like adding this glow here. Yeah, and I'm pretty much liking it. Maybe a bit like lower the overall amount of the effect. But like this is before and this is after. So that's about that. And final thing that I wanted to do is remove this thing here. Obviously the car is old, it's E46, but this thing annoys me. So let's just do thing like this and boom, there we go. So yeah, it's good actually. And basically, this is how I edit my images from the scratch.
This is it for today's tutorial, and I have a question for you. In your opinion, what is the fair price for Lightroom presets? Leave your thoughts in the comment section down below. I hope you learned something new from this Lightroom tutorial, and your car images will look great. As always, I will catch you in the next one. Till then, stay awesome!